Hello, everyone. So today I have a huge mess behind me. Interested to find out why? Stay tuned. Hello, everyone. So today we are discussing this awesome brand collaboration that I'm doing. So this week I am working with Rebag to showcase my designer bag collection. Such a cool opportunity, and I am so honored that they went with my submission. But this has been such a neat opportunity to get everything out of the closets, lay it all out, and see just truly how much shopping I've done in the past year. It's a little bad. But no, seriously guys, this is such an awesome opportunity. If you're not familiar with Rebag, we're going to discuss them here in a little bit and kind of dive in a little bit more. But first, while it's all out, I just thought we'd do a quick look at my bag collection. All right, so before we dive into the Rebag details, let's go ahead and take a look at my collection while it's all laying out here on the table. Now, this isn't including my designer luggage or shoes. I still have to get those out of the closet here in a little bit. But let's just go through and kind of reminisce, shall we say. Now, obviously, this collection has gotten a lot bigger since I posted my collection video a few months ago. I've been a little crazy this year, I'm not gonna lie. Let's start down here. So the oldest bag in my collection, both in age and length in my collection, is this Gucci pouch. Zane actually got that for me for our third or fourth anniversary, and I think it's from the late 70s or early 80s. It's a really old piece. Again, I don't use it a whole lot just because it is a little delicate, but fabulous nonetheless. This was actually the first bag that I purchased from Rebag. This is the Louis Vuitton Reporter PM in the Taiga Leather Apicia Green. That's kind of what got me hooked on Rebag, you guys. They did such a fabulous job with that transaction that I just keep going back for more and more and more. Other notable pieces are this gorgeous Python clutch from Gucci. I had my eyes on this for about a month before I pulled the trigger. They had 15% off for the 4th of July, and I jumped at that offer. My first Hermes bag, the Rio pouch or Rio clutch in the PM size, also came from Rebag. I also got my black envelope flap from Balenciaga, and I think one or two pieces of Taiga luggage as well that I'll get out later. Other notable pieces in my collection, though, I have this gorgeous vintage Marley bag from Louis Vuitton, the Palace bag that we all know I ran through Munich to buy, my favorite Prada bag, the Prada Esplanade shoulder bag, a few pieces from my ever-growing YSL collection, the new Sade clutch that I just picked up in Chicago. And you guys, something else that Rebag is doing, not only do they sell bags like you would think by the name, but they're also selling designer jewelry and accessories, which is so cool. So I'm going to showcase some of my pieces. So in my collection, I have this gorgeous cocktail ring from Versace. This one features a beautiful lapis lazuli stone, and then of course Medusa sits on top. I also have a couple of brooches from the Gucci runways. These are both from different collections and years, but they're both very gorgeous. I especially love the detailing on this big one. Look at that on the back. So much attention to detail. I also love to wear that one with this necklace, of course. And here's a cuff from Saint Laurent. And then, of course, my Versace Medusa head cufflinks. I actually picked these up at the Metzingen outlet when we were there for Christmas a few years ago. Another notable mention is my gorgeous Burberry Porsum fox head clutch. This one came straight off the runway in 2012, I believe. And then other notable mentions, we, of course, have the five Balenciaga envelope flap clutches. I have the Raisin, Blue Tropical, Rose Bonbon. Oh, I forget the color of yellow. And then of course, black. Anyway, when it comes to small accessories, I of course have a heat stamped Louis Vuitton luggage tag. Can't have a Louis Vuitton collection without one of those. That actually used to hang on my Speedy 40 several years ago. I stupidly sold that one. Then of course my fuchsia coin and card holder, a little Gucci Blooms, some vintage wallets from Louis Vuitton, my new Brazza wallet. Now this Gucci Ophidia card case I actually picked up when we were in Venice. There was a bit of a rainstorm that evening. Zane and I were having kind of a date night out. They offered us champagne. Zane bought driving moccasins and I got the card holder there. And what else do we have? There's my Hermes, there's a Gucci clutch that is made for factory, but it's still fabulous nonetheless. I love the bamboo detailing on that. Believe it or not, that is my only Gucci bag with bamboo details. We might have to fix that here in the future. Here is the Balenciaga triangle clutch, Balenciaga clip clutch, the Danube, and of course the puffy Balenciaga bag. But yeah, that is pretty much where my collection is at right now. I'll do a more in-depth video here either later this year or early next year. But let's take a moment and discuss what Rebag's all about. All right, so that was my collection at a glance. It's definitely grown. Let me know down in the comments what you think of it so far. Now, when it comes to Rebag, I absolutely love the concept of the pre-owned market in general. I think, first of all, the most the crucial key aspect of it is sustainability. We're kind of in a day and age where we need to consciously think about, you know, how we're using our materials and the waste that we're creating with a consumer culture. And I think that part of the pre-owned market really kind of helps cut down on that. I mean, these bags are so beautifully made and in most cases handmade as well by trained artisans. There's really no reason why they should only have, you know, a 5 to 10 year shelf life. I mean, some of the bags here in my collection are 20 plus years old and they still look amazing. So I think that is a huge component to the pre-owned market and kind of the value behind it. Another thing is saving money. A lot of these bags, you know, even the ones that I bought full price, you know, right off the rack when they first came out, not even 6 months later, you could start finding them for hundreds less. And that is a huge factor, especially if you are a collector like I am. I'm not trying to blow all my money, you know, all at once. You need to be, you know, a little bit more mindful with your finances and whatnot. And also the pre-owned market helps you find those, you know, pieces that got away. If you're looking for something rare from Louis Vuitton or maybe a runway item from Gucci, you know, something that you missed out on 2, 3, 4, even 10 years ago, you can now find on sites like Rebag. And I think that is truly amazing. If you remember the story of my Burberry Porcelain bag, I had wanted that bag ever since it came out. And then through luxury, you know, resellers and pre-owned markets, I was able to make that a reality. And I absolutely love that. Now, I myself have been shopping with Rebag. I think I bought my first bag in 2018, right before we went to Italy. It was the Reporter. It was such a flawless transaction, you guys. It was amazing. I think that Rebag has really fine-tuned the resell market, and they've really added a lot of technological aspects to it as well. Something that they just announced, you know, in a few months ago was the addition of the Claire AI system. So essentially what that is you can take a photo of any designer handbag, and 90%+ of the time, it's correct with what it is. So say you're out to lunch or out to dinner, and one of your friends is carrying a bag, and you're like, hey, you know, I see that that's a Gucci bag, but which one is it, and what season is it from? They may not know. You know, not everyone is an avid collector like we are. So all you have to do with the Claire AI is literally take a photo of it, and 9 times out of 10, it is correct with telling you the brand, the name of the bag, and then it also gives you what it should sell for as well. So that way, you know, you can check Rebag and see what it's selling for. Now, that same technology can also be used in your own closet. Say I have this Prada bag and, you know, I'm not using it anymore. It's just taking up space and I want to use the funds towards something else. All I have to do is snap a photo of it, and then Claire AI within minutes will tell me, you know, what it is and how much Rebag's willing to sell it for or buy it for from me. And as someone like myself who has a background in sales, something like that when I was working in luxury retail would have been amazing to have. So essentially, as a salesperson, all you have to do is take a photo of the bag. You know, say you're sitting with a client and they're not sure of the resale potential of a certain item. Use Clear Eye, snap a photo of that bag, and then show them like, hey, you know, that bag is going to retain its value, or this is what it's selling for on the pre-owned market right now. And I think that's such a neat tool that they took the time and developed that. I think it took them like 6 years or so to come up with that neat technology. I just absolutely love that. So for this collaboration, I just had to take between like 5 to 7 photos of my collection. I've kind of brainstormed some neat ways to showcase each piece. I also have a couple outfits picked out for a couple modeling shots, but I just need to submit those. I need to do this YouTube video and a couple of Instagram posts. And essentially what they're going to do is showcase my collection on their blog, The Vault. Now, if you're not familiar with The Vault over on Rebag, essentially it's their online blog. And on there, they have a ton of awesome information. They have like a handbag 101. They also have what's kind of trending and forecasts and things like that. Interviews like this one where people are showing off their designer bag collections. They even have a few collaborations with different influencers and with their kind of capsule collections of things they've picked on Rebag to showcase under their own names. And it's just a fun website, you guys. I'm gonna have all the links down below, of course. I'm so excited. I can't say that enough. I'm so excited that this is one of my first kind of big brand collaborations, and I'm excited to participate. So follow along while I take some photos, and my vault is launched. But finish this video first and then hit the link down below to check out the article. All right, so before I get started, I have everything organized kind of how I want to shoot it. So I'm thinking I definitely need an organized flap clutch moment with the Balenciaga bags. I might do like a fan or something in like a color block type display. I definitely want to showcase the black and gold pieces, the really luxe items there. I'm going to have a jewelry moment here with all of these beautiful bits and baubles. These bags that stand up, I might do like in our library, kind of have like a makeshift closet moment. But yeah, this is kind of what I'm thinking about doing. So stay tuned and let's see what some of these look like. All right, guys, so I just finished the first photo, and I just have some of my jewels here laying out. I have some pieces from Versace, the YSL cuff, some pieces from Gucci, and of course, one of my favorite necklaces. And you'll never guess what it's sitting on. a shirt from ASOS through the magic of photography. All right, and with another little trick of the eye, I have set up a faux closet here in the library. I just pulled out a few things from a couple of the shelves, set up my bags as if it was a beautiful walk-in coat closet. So hopefully we can get this one to turn out as good as the jewelry. All right, so this is part of one of my shots featuring my new Python bag from Gucci. And I've never shown it on my channel, but how fun is this Gucci fan? Perfect for the beach or maybe a summer wedding. All right, on to the next shot. All right, so this is the last setup I took. It was just kind of like a black and gold moment. The shot turned out really cool, so I hope they like it over at Rebag. All right, so we're heading over to a location to do it, just like a quick modeling shot. Zane will be our photographer today as usual. And I will just be wearing vintage Givenchy again, and the YSL Sade clutch for this shot. So hopefully we can get this pretty quick. It's supposed to rain soon, and I really don't want to get my new YSL stuck in the rain, so we're going to get this done as fast as possible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. All right, so we finally just finished that up. It only took us like 5 minutes, super quick. So we just did some close-ups of the bags, just like interesting angles and whatnot to kind of make it look artistic. So hopefully they turned out and it's what Rebag is looking for. But I think with all the setup shots that we did around the apartment and then this final photo, I think we might have nailed it. I think we did a pretty good job.
I think we did a good job, yeah.
I hope they like it. Yeah, so let's go back, maybe take another shot or two, finish things up and call it a day.
All right, so that's it. I didn't use everything in my collection. There's a lot that didn't really make the cut for the photographs, but I think what I did turned out really good. The jewelry shot's gorgeous. The little faux closet setup I did is pretty neat. I love the black and gold moment. And I ended up switching around the Python bag on the Tiger table in my library. So to see the final outcome of that, you'll have to go and check out the article. Like I said, it's linked down below, rebag.com. It's the vault. Make sure to go to the interviews and everything, and I should be the newest one listed. It just went live. So link down below, check it out. Also, before you go, hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell icon, and shoot me a comment down below. Let me know what you think I did. This is my first collaboration with a brand, so I am super excited, and I hope to do more soon. All right, guys. Well, I'll catch you in the next video. Have a great night. Bye.